Hey everyone, Phoenix 1.7 has officially been released, so now it's time to update. But how? Follow along with me and I'll show you the resources you can use to help making updating Phoenix 1.7 go as smoothly as possible, regardless of what current version of Phoenix you are using. So check it out. To get started with the Phoenix update is just go over to thephoenixframework.org. And you will have to click on guides. The thing that is a little disorienting is when you click on guides, you won't really see anything for the changelog. And that is because it is up. Scroll up on the left scroll bar and you will see the changelog for 1.7. If you click on that, we are taking to the changelog for Phoenix 1.7. The awesome change in Phoenix 1.7. is the introduction of verified routes. Verified routes allows you to more easily specify routes to URL or assets using the sigil P macro. This is really convenient because no longer do you have to remember how to generate the path to a specific page on your site. Now you can intuitively use the relative path for that page by doing sigil P. And sessions/new or sigil p posts. Really easy, really convenient, and it will still vet your URL whether it matches up with your routes. You'll still get the same errors, so you're not going to be generating links to pages that don't exist in your application. And the other really cool thing is it allows you to use sigil p for static assets. No longer do you have to remember the special helper method for static assets. Now you could just do the relative path to your static asset and it will generate the URL and load that up on your page too. It just makes things a little bit easier when trying to deal with URLs or for anything in your application. The other thing that came in with Phoenix that is optional is a new component structure to Phoenix 1.7. Now Phoenix has departed away from the current structure where there were separate folders for views and separate folders for templates. Now Phoenix comes with a new syntax that lets you render components easier and treat them more as a HTML asset. And that is a completely optional thing you can opt into because that's a little bit more involved because it's a change in folder structure or change in hierarchy for your application that we'll take a look into in a minute. In order to get started, the best way to do it is actually to click the upgrade guide provided by Chris McCord. And that will take you to a gist showing you how to go from 1.6 to 1.7. Before doing the actual upgrade, I highly recommend that you go through and you do a regular update to a lot of your dependencies in your application. You can go ahead and run the mix hex.outdated just to see what's outdated in your application. Update those to make sure they're at their latest. Make sure you have the best compatibility before you even try to hit 1.7. Go through that, do those updates, run your tests, make sure your app is good, and then go and try to do the 1.7 update just to make sure it's going to go as smooth as possible because you want to reduce the friction that you're trying to update a library and then that library might not be compatible with 1.7 or at least that version of the library is not compatible with 1.7 because of the dependency restrictions and whatnot. So after going through that and doing your due diligence, making sure to update your other libraries, now you can actually get started. Just following this guide, updating your Phoenix, doing depths get, removing certain option, removing the Phoenix and get text options in the compiler's option inside your MixExs. If you take a look at the console when you're starting your web server, you'll actually see this warning also about removing this dependency in the compiler's option. So pay attention to everything that's happening inside the console when you're running your server. Next is updating your formatter EXS and with a couple suggested changes, the main one being the Phoenix Live View HTML formatter. Another thing to note is that don't follow this verbatim and do a copy and paste because this is also missing the ecto_sql option that might already exist in some of your application configuration. Just be careful with that. And in this guide, there's actually a call out to that in the comments below. Another breaking change that has been deprecated because how we're moving to a component-based structure is things have been moved out of Phoenix Live View and moved out of Phoenix View and have been folded into what is now Phoenix Component, a brand new module. that contains helpers to render components more in a markup style. Instead of using helpers to, in this case, do a live title tag, instead we use a live title component and wrap our content of what we want to be in the live title in that tag. This is the new thing with Phoenix 1.7. That is, again, an opt-in option, but if you look at new 1.7 code, you will see this new syntax of how to actually render stuff, which I personally like because it starts to feel more like a UI library. It's very cool to see that. And some of these options are opt-in and some are not. In this case, this is a deprecation. It's better to follow along with this. And in his description, he talks about what happened and why. And then the optional update is to add in the verified routes. This is the guide to add in that SigilP verified routes into your application. I highly recommend doing this because it's just so much nicer to specify your routes using the SigilP, both your URLs and your static assets. I highly recommend doing this because it's going to make just cleaner code and it's just a lot less cognitive load to remember how the heck do I render a route? How do I generate a URL to a path in my application or to an asset? And as you're going through this, go down and read the comments because there are a couple gotchas. I encountered this gotcha and it has to do with GetFlash. GetFlash is deprecated, is no longer part of the helpers. You will actually need to directly invoke phoenixflash.get and then give it a flash. Following this comment here will get you unblocked on that. You'll quickly encounter that. And then over here, someone also commented and called out that the SQL was missing on here. This is a really smooth update if you're going from 1.6 to 1.7, but it's a little scarier when you're going from an earlier version, 1.4, 1.5. Well, I got a tool that you can use and it is called Phoenix Diff. If you go to phoenixdiff.org, it's a cool tool that generates a diff between two different Phoenix versions. By default, it's set to the latest 1.6 version, and it's doing a diff to the 1.7 version. But you select your source, and you select your target. And then it will do a line-by-line comparison of all the files that are generated by Phoenix from one version to the other. Whether it's a new version, whether it's changing lines, whether it's a complete deletion of a file, it's all there for you to see. So you can really dive into what has changed, maybe some configurations that you're missing. If you're a little bit paranoid like me and you're like, maybe I missed something during my updates and stuff like that, a really awesome tool. I actually like to do the side-by-side view to compare things. And this is really awesome because you can specify a version all the way back to version 1. If you're on version 1.5, selecting a random version, we'll be able to see a comparison between those two. So we can see that on version 1.5, we had Ecto and Phoenix, but once we're on 1.7, we have to specify Ecto SQL and other options, like here, the call out from Ms. Chris McCord did for the formatter. We can see that changes here. So if you really wanted to dive into this and really compare the configurations of your application, I highly recommend checking this out. Or if you're just curious and wanted to see what changed and what's new without actually having to add those changes to your existing application, highly recommend it, especially with the new Phoenix component structure. That's going to cause some breaking changes to your views and templates for your Phoenix applications, because a lot of that stuff that we are currently using in 1.6 and before have all been deprecated to a new style. We can actually take a look and see what that looks like. Actually let's go to the latest 1.6 so we can just see a little bit less changes in here. Because Phoenix now includes Tailwind, a lot of the old styles are just gone because now Phoenix 1.7 is leveraging Tailwind by default. We're going to see a lot of CSS going away. We can also see a couple tweaks here, like this wasn't called out about underscore info. Over here, the option was info, but now it's underscore info. We can kind of see changes here that we might not catch. If you don't have Tailwind already configured in your application, you could see what the default configuration for Tailwind is. Or if you wanted to move from 1.6 to 1.7 and update your Tailwind configuration to match what 1.7 is offering, you can include that. If you already had Tailwind in here, some of this configuration you already have, but some new stuff that I found is a lot of these plugins here. So Tailwind forms, adding different variants for the loaders, All that's in here. There's been changes to the top bar that you can now see and include if you wanted to add in features that they added in for delaying showing. So it's a really handy tool going in here. The part that's really interesting that I want to get into is the new components structure to Phoenix. And now with Phoenix 1.7, if you were to generate a brand new Phoenix 1.7 application, you're going to no longer see inside the web module a templates folder or a view folder, because all of that stuff has been folded either into a components folder or into the controller folder, with having the views, the templates, now in a hierarchy structured within those folders. And a lot of those helper components that were generated for modals and stuff like that in 1.7 are inside a file called core components within the components folder. And here we can actually see what the new components look like, which I find it really interesting, because these new components now look like UI library components. Or if you use Surface UI for Phoenix, it looks a lot like that too, where for a component, for a modal, for example, you can specify attributes for that modal that you want a modal to receive, and also slots of targets where you want to render. If you want to target a slot to render in the title, so in your modal, if you want to have a header, a title, a body, a footer, you can create slots that you can individually target. And then if you want to render that modal, this is what the example code looks like for rendering that modal. Again, it looks like regular markup instead of trying to use a helper to render some sort of template. Instead, you can invoke that template like a regular HTML markup. Super cool. I highly recommend going through this and checking it out. All of this, again, is optional. You don't have to go through adding this stuff in. You can continue to use your existing markup, all the same stuff that you wanted to use before. In fact, I suggest not making this upgrade unless you really, really want to, because taking a look at the app web, a lot of stuff's changed in here. And if you were to try to take all of this and just plop it into your code, you would break a lot of different things in your application. You would have to make sure to include certain things like route helpers. You would have to uncomment this or set this to true to continue to use the route helpers that you're currently using in your markup inside your templates. And a couple other, again, I don't recommend it unless you really want to spend the time trying to either convert everything over or trying to go through and trying to make sure that you support the new stuff, core components, component style, and your old stuff. That's it. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. I will be dropping links to all these resources in the description below for the Phoenix changelog, Chris McCord's guide, and also the awesome tool Phoenix Diff that you can use to check out what's changed and make it a little bit easier if you are upgrading from any Phoenix version to another Phoenix version. If you like what you see, please consider subscribing to the channel. I greatly appreciate it, and I will catch you in the next video. Peace.